Thank you. Please. Thank you. Good to see this cabinet and staff together. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Please. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It's good to see you all. Particularly good to see my granddaughter sitting in the front row here. Hi, Finn. How are you, honey? For over 200 years, America has carried on the greatest experiment in self-government in the history of the world. And that's not hyperbole. That's a fact. We're the people. The people vote and choose their own leaders, and they do it peacefully. And we're in a democracy. The will of the people always prevails. Yesterday, I spoke with President-elect Trump to congratulate him on his victory. And I assured him that I'd direct my entire administration to work with his team to ensure a peaceful and orderly transition. That's what the American people deserve. Yesterday, I also spoke with Vice President Harris. She's been a partner and a public servant. She ran an inspiring campaign, and everyone got to see something that I learned early on to respect so much, her character. She has a backbone like a ramrod. She has great character, true character. She gave her whole heart and effort, and she and her entire team should be proud of the campaign they ran. You know, the struggle for the soul of America, since our very founding, has always been an ongoing debate and still vital today. I know for some people, it's a time for victory, to state the obvious. For others, it's a time of loss. Campaigns are contests of competing visions. The country chooses one or the other. We accept the choice the country made. I've said many times, you can't love your country only when you win. You can't love your neighbor only when you agree. Something that I hope we can do, no matter who you voted for, is see each other not as adversaries, but as fellow Americans. Bring down the temperature. I also hope we can lay to rest the question about the integrity of the American electoral system. It is honest, it is fair, and it is transparent. And it can be trusted, win or lose. I also hope we can restore the respect for all our election workers who busted their necks and took risks at the outset. We should thank them. Thank them for staffing voting sites, counting the votes, protecting the very integrity of the election. Many of them are volunteers who do it simply out of love for their country. And as they did, their duty as citizens, I will do my duty as president. I'll fulfill my oath, and I will honor the Constitution. On January 20th, we'll have a peaceful transfer of power here in America. To all our incredible staff, supporters, cabinet members, all the people who have been hanging out with me for the last 4 years, God love you, as my mother would say, thank you so much. You put so much into the past 4 years. I know it's a difficult time. You're hurting. I hear you and I see you. But don't forget. Don't forget all that we accomplished. It's been an historic presidency. Not because I'm president, because what we've done, what you've done. A presidency for all Americans. Much of the work we've done is already being felt by the American people, but the vast majority of it will not be felt. We felt over the next 10 years. We have legislation we passed that's just only now just really kicking in. We're going to see over $1 trillion worth of infrastructure work done, changing people's lives in rural communities and communities that are in real difficulty, because it takes time to get it done. And so much more, it's going to take time. But it's there. The road ahead is clear, assuming we sustain it. There's so much we can get done and will get done based on the way the legislation was passed. And it's truly historic. You know, We're leaving behind the strongest economy in the world. I know people are still hurting, but things are changing rapidly. Together, we've changed America for the better. Now we have 74 days to finish the term, our term. Let's make every day count. That's the responsibility we have to the American people. Look, folks, you all know it in your lives. Setbacks are unavoidable, but giving up is unforgivable. Setbacks are unavoidable, but giving up is unforgivable. We all get knocked down. But the measure of our character, as my dad would say, is how quickly we get back up. Remember, a defeat does not mean we are defeated. We lost this battle. The America of your dreams is calling for you to get back up. That's the story of America for over 240 years and counting. It's a story for all of us, not just some of us. The American experiment endures. We're going to be okay, but we need to stay engaged. We need to keep going. And above all, we need to keep the faith. I'm so proud to have worked with all of you. I really mean it. I sincerely mean it. God bless you all. God bless America. And may God protect our troops. Thank you, thank you, thank you.